Hi everyone, and welcome back to my channel. I'm Jen, and this is my channel. Welcome. So, before we get started with, I am going to draw the card, but I wanted to show you guys, I transplanted some of my little succulents that I showed you yesterday in my video. This is the one that's not doing so well. He has a little hole in his leaf. I don't know what happened, but I planted him, and I'm hoping that maybe he'll come back to life. So there was a couple of people that were concerned that the dish was too small for all six, and it is definitely too small for all six, so I ordered another one, and I have three in this one, of course. Also, some people were concerned about my cats and eating them. These have sat out on my bar all night and they haven't bothered them, so I don't think that they will bother them, but I am going to be cautious of that because the shelf that they're going to live on is the top shelf of the bookshelf when I get it, and there's nothing around the bookshelf. It's just going to be like out in the open. Well, against a wall, but like out in the open, so there's no way for them to get up there, so they'll be quite safe once they get to their permanent home. And for now, they haven't touched them, so I think they're okay. But I will keep an eye on them. All right, so let's pick a card of the day, and then we'll get into the other stuff that I have to talk about. It's Friday, guys. We made it to the weekend. I hope you guys, if you have any plans, have a good weekend. I have kind of a busy week coming up next week. I downloaded Dr. Jason Fung's intermittent fasting book, and that's what I plan to read this weekend. So that's my weekend plans, but I have a pretty busy week coming up next week with a lot of changes, and I'll fill you in on that stuff later, but clean the desk. My vibes speak louder than my words, and boy, do I need to hear that today. That's a perfect card for me. And we will get into why that is a perfect card for me in just a second. All right, now I'm going to talk about how yesterday went, because yesterday was a pretty bad day and it did not go as I had hoped or how I had planned for it to go. My plans for yesterday was to get a few videos done of things I wanted to talk about, actual topic videos, but that didn't happen. I had a disagreement with somebody close to me, and I found out that they had been lying to me, and then I had a disagreement with somebody else and very close to me, and I forgot about my boundaries. I knew I had set boundaries for myself that were healthy boundaries and that I shouldn't be crossing. But I let those boundaries down, and I let some people back into my life, and it bit me in the butt. So that put me in a really bad mood. So first of all, my food for breakfast went really well. I'll insert a clip here of what I had. First meal of the day, 8:30 a.m. There's 2/3 of a cup of All Bran Buds, with 1 cup of almond milk and 1 cup of raspberries and 1 cup of blueberries. I didn't have my tea this morning, but I did have my water. I have drank about half of my water so far, half of the 63 ounces. So I'll be finishing that with my breakfast. So everything was okay for breakfast, and then right after breakfast, mid-morning, is when everything broke loose, kind of, and stuff started going downhill. So I was sleepy and tired anyhow because I didn't sleep the night before. I'm dealing with my insomnia phase. I go through this quite often, and I've went through this since my early 20s. A lot of people have asked in the comments because I look tired or not well, but it's usually just because I'm very tired. So I am currently, it's getting better though, I'm turning myself back around again from my insomnia, but I didn't sleep all the night before, so I was in a bad mood, so I was like, I'm just gonna go to sleep. And I slept until about 4:30 or 5 o'clock off and on. So I had planned on going to play bingo with my Golden Girl friends, and it started at 6, and I needed to get dressed and do a couple things on the computer first, and I was hungry. I slept through lunch, so I ended up not really having much. I'll insert a picture of what I made, and I took this with me to bingo. It was the only thing I could think of to grab quickly. I didn't want to take a salad to bingo because that would be kind of weird. So this is what I took with me to bingo. So my plan was to have that as a snack to hold me over through bingo until around 8:30 or so, until I came back to my apartment and I was able to make my actual dinner meal, which was going to be, I forget what it was going to be, but I think it was going to be something with chicken maybe. And so that ended up not happening. I did eat that I showed you in the picture, my walnuts, the almond butter, and the cheese, the little wedges of cheese. So that did hold me over because it was a lot of protein and it was the good fats and the nuts. So I was good with that. I also took my water with me. And while I was at bingo, I got, I guess you could say, triggered by another situation that I sometimes don't know how to deal with situations and people that are difficult to deal with. Sometimes I try to just be as positive as I can, but sometimes it's really hard to be positive to people that are negative all the time. So that's why I usually just don't deal with negative people. I just ignore the situation or ignore them because it's too difficult for me, and I never know how to do it right, and I always second guess myself. So there was a negative situation that I ended up avoiding. I didn't stay for the whole bingo. I only stayed for the first half and I left. And then that, on top of everything else, just, I felt horrible. And I'm going to be honest with you guys, I wanted to binge really, really badly. But luckily, I guess you could say luckily, I have nothing in my apartment that I would consider a binge to binge on, which is good, I guess, for me. It's definitely good that I didn't have anything. So I got angry because I didn't have anything to binge on. And I had planned on ordering a pizza. This is being completely honest with you guys, being transparent, because this is my life and what I deal with, so I'm just laying it all out there for you. I was just in that place where I was fed up, so I made myself a drink. I made myself a whiskey sour, and I planned on drinking that and kind of chilling out and relaxing a little bit because I didn't have the food to give me that fix and that comfort, so I decided to have a drink, and hopefully that would have given me some kind of relief and comfort until I was able to order a pizza. So I'll insert a picture here of my drink. So I drank that, and in the midst of drinking it, what I did was, I don't know, I can't give you exact measurements or how much alcohol it was in it. I filled that glass completely full with ice. That's a large iced coffee drink from McDonald's. I just saved the cup because, as I've told you before, I have a thing with saving cups. It's a little kind of a hoarding thing, I think. But so I filled that cup with ice, and then I filled it halfway with whiskey, and then I filled it the rest of the way with sour mix, and that's what I drank. And I had almost virtually an empty stomach, and I was tired anyhow, and the alcohol hit me really hard. And I got goofy, and I actually pretty much passed out. Not literally like passed out, cold passed out, but I fell asleep for about an hour, and when I woke back up, it was 10:30, and it was too late to order a pizza because I live in a small town and they stopped delivering. We don't have delivery here at all hours of the night like in big cities. So that was another good thing, that there was nowhere to deliver a pizza, get a pizza delivered from. So I finished the drink that I had there, and I was pretty well intoxicated by that time. I put some posts on Facebook that I regretted and that I deleted this morning. But what I found was alcohol is not the thing that gives me a fix like food does, because I still felt frustrated after I drank it. I was looking for that fix and it didn't work. If that would have been food, if I had binged, I would have felt better and then I would have been happy. Of course, I would have been regretful for actually eating the food. I am regretful for drinking alcohol and drinking the sour mix, because the sour mix has sugar in it, of course. So I'm not happy about that, but at least it wasn't a binge of food. That would have been, I think, worse, because I think that would have just set off a chain reaction of behaviors that might have led down a wrong path. So it's the lesser of the evils, I guess, if you want to say it that way. It wasn't good at all that I did that. I have not attended an OA meeting in the last week and a half, so that's something that I think I need to get back to, because I was doing a lot better when I was attending OA meetings regularly. I have my next therapy appointment next Thursday. This was my off week. So anyhow, that was all that I had to eat or drink yesterday. And of course, I had 63 ounces of water plus like another half of the 63. So I had that, and today is my fasting day. So far today I have had 13 ounces of green tea, and I've had about half of my 63 ounces of water so far. It's 10 a.m. So I'm feeling better today. I'm feeling a little hungover and a little but I woke up at 5, I took my shower, I slept really well, obviously, so hopefully that sleeping pattern, now that I've gotten into the pattern of sleeping at night, hopefully then tonight I will sleep at a normal hour and it will be better. I still don't have any resolutions from the disagreements or fights or whatever you want to call it with the people that I had yesterday. I don't know how I'm going to handle those situations for now. I've blocked those people from my life. I don't know what I'll do if I see them or if they actually come to me in person, and I don't know how that will be. But for now, this situation is taken care of. But eventually it will have to be worked out, I guess. I don't know. It's yet to be seen how that will end. But that's how my Thursday went. I find myself getting a little obsessed with the scale again, because I keep wanting to see if I've dropped any more weight, because it's so exciting that I lost a big amount of weight in a week, and I want to keep seeing if I've gone down anymore, and I keep wanting to see the scale move. And that's one of the reasons why I put the scale away and stopped weighing regularly, weekly, in the first place, is because I was becoming obsessed with it, and that's not healthy either. So like I said, today's my fasting day. I'll just be eating dinner, and then tomorrow I have a full day of eating. So Sunday you'll see what I ate a day, the whole day plus dinner tonight. So we'll move into the mirror work, readings, and meditation, as well as affirmations for today. Today starts the second week of our readings, and it's day 8 of the mirror work by Louise Hay, 21 Days to Heal Your Life. And today's topic is loving your inner child, and it's part 1. Today you look beyond the adult you see in the mirror, and you meet your inner child. And the little snippet that I want to read to you out of the reading today is, every age you have been is within you, in your consciousness and in your memory. As a child, when something went wrong, you tended to believe that there was something wrong with you. Children develop the idea that if only they could do everything right, their parents would love them and wouldn't punish them. Often we turn off or tune out around the age of 5. We make that decision because we think there is something wrong with us, and we're not going to have anything to do with this child anymore. There is also a parent inside of us as well. And for most of us, this inner parent is scolding the inner child, almost nonstop. If you listen to your inner dialogue, you can hear the scolding. You can hear the parent tell you what you're doing wrong and that you're not good enough. Every time you're scared, realize that this is the child within you that is scared. The adult isn't afraid. Yet it has disconnected and isn't there for the child. The adult and the child need to develop a relationship with each other. Talk to your inner child about everything you do. I know it might sound silly, but it works. Let your inner child know that no matter what happens, you will never turn away from it. You will never leave it, and you will always be there, and you will always love it. Very wise words. A lot to think about as well. All right, we're going to close now with the meditation as well as the heart thought for the day. I'm going to start with the meditation. So hopefully we will relax a little bit and then I will read the heart thought of the day. Let go and relax. Take a nice deep breath and close your eyes. Take another deep breath and allow your body to completely relax. Let your attention move to your toes and allow them to go completely limp. Now relax your insteps, your heels, and your ankles. Let your feet become heavy. Allow this relaxation to move up into your calves and your knees. Continue to move this warmth and relaxation into the rest of your body. Allow your waistline to release and then feel peacefulness move up into your chest, expanding through your collarbone and into your shoulders. Allow your arms to let go. Allow your elbows to relax. Let your lower arms, wrists, and hands relax. Let the last of the tension move out through your fingertips. Let your neck relax, then your jaw, your cheeks, and all of the muscles around your eyes. Let your forehead and your scalp relax. Let go. Let go. Relax. Okay, hopefully now we are all relaxed and we will read the heart thought of the day. And it is called, I Embrace My Inner Child with Love. Take care of your inner child. It is the child who is frightened. It is the child who is hurting. It is the child who does not know what to do. Be there for your child. Embrace it. Love it. And do whatever you can to take care of its needs. Be sure to let your child know that no matter what happens, You will always be there for it. You will never turn it away or desert it. You will always love this child. All right, that was day 8, beginning of week 2. I hope you all enjoyed that, and I will see you again tomorrow. Have a good day, everyone. Bye. Boop.